either.
G'day, I'm Justin from Bainbridge Technologies. Today we're here to talk about putting together a power budget. Now you ask, what's a power budget? Is it how much you want to spend on the system? No, it's not. It's an idea of how much we're going to use. So we need to look at, in our motorhome, caravan, camper trailer, even our vessel, we need to look at what requirements we have for power. 240 volt power, of course, and also our DC, so the power we're using from our batteries, and also putting back into them, which is very important. Now, we need to determine, first of all, how much power we're going to require to run our certain devices. Are we going to have things like 240 volt refrigeration in our boat, as well as kettles or hot plates going at the same time while we're out on the water? Or are we just going to have singular items running at one point? We need to look at that. If we're going to run multiple items at once, we need to add them up and work out what our total or peak load's going to be. That way we can match the appropriate converter to suit that. Once we've determined that, we also need to have a look at what sort of draws we're going to have from our DC system, you know, what's coming from our batteries. Is there multiple devices that are pulling power from our 12 volt system, like cigarette sockets that we have bits and pieces plugged into? We need to look at that as well and include that into the system. By doing that, we can get a better understanding of how much power we need to put back into the batteries when we are back at shore or we've got the generator fired up. Now that's great. Speaking of batteries, we need to make sure that we have the right amount of batteries for the system we're going to require. I mean, here we've got the 4000 watt Victron Quattro. It's an inverter charger combination. Now this, running at full load, is going to pull multiple hundreds of amps from our battery. So if we were to put a little single 100 amp hour battery in there, it's not going to last very long as far as run time. But more importantly, we're going to kill that battery in a couple of months, and we don't want that. So we need to spec the batteries to the units we're using. We may have to have 400, 500, 600, 700 amp hours connected to this inverter charger to make sure we get the full potential from it. So sit down before you go and purchase your next power system. Work out what your total loads and total draws are going to be, and have a think about which unit's going to suit it, both as how much power we need to invert, and in the case of these guys being inverter charger, how much power we're going to get back into our batteries when we're back on shore power as well. Now that's the first step that we require when we put together our power budget. If you need any more information on that, jump onto our website, www.baintech.com.au. You'll be able to view our range of inverter charger combinations, as well as just battery chargers and inverters, and get some helpful hints along the way on how to best come up with a power solution for yourself.